Lean thinking is basically looking at your business processes end to end, and really what you're trying to do is listen to your customer, trying to establish and understand exactly what it is your customer, and then deliver that to your customer in the most efficient and effective manner. Invariably what tends to happen in most businesses, there will be blockages, obstacles, things go wrong. In terms of giving the customer what they want. And really lean, it's just a very sort of thought through process where you actually look at the end-to-end processes, identify what the constraints and the blockages are, and then engage your people to address those blockages. We have a team of seven advisors and experienced practitioners in terms of lean, productivity improvement, supply chain management. The seven of us then would have an engineering background, and it's all based out there in the commercial world. So there's a wide range of experience and knowledge within the team, and really it's that experience and knowledge that we're trying to transfer across to our customers.
My name is Tracy Moore, and I'm the Human Resources and Training Manager here at the City Hotel. We wanted to provide our customers with a high quality service at the right price, and we realised we needed to get more efficient. And in order to do that, we approached InvestNI to help us with this project. For us, lean was all about getting smarter, not working harder. It was about looking at all of our processes from start to finish. Even the minute processes can always have waste. So for us, it was looking at the processes and identifying waste and eliminating the waste. Also, lean principles helped us as an employee engagement tool, because all of our employees had to be engaged from the front line right through to management.
City Hotel were great because they had no preconceptions of what lean was. They weren't a manufacturing site, so lean to them was all about continuous improvement. So they really bought into this idea of value-added activities versus non-value-added activities. Before that, they maybe just saw all the activities they were doing as work, and everybody was busy. But once they got that mindset of what were the non-value added activities that weren't providing any value for the customer, they were able to eliminate them and just make small incremental improvements. The management team there, they made the commitment that they were going to free their managers up to attend a 3-hour lean fundamental training session. That meant that all the heads of department were able to buy into this mindset of continuous improvement. And from that, all departments were tasked with coming up with improvements and implementing the improvements in their areas.
The productivity improvement team were really helpful. They helped us deliver tailor-made training designed specifically for our business needs. The key learning in the tailor-made training was about recognising value-added and non-value-added. It made us question our processes. Why do we do certain things the way we do it? Is it because that's the way they've always been done? In all departments, we organised lean meetings and we identified lean champions. And within those meetings, we just opened the floor and we talked about the processes. And from our frontline staff, we were given absolute wonderful ideas. For example, napkins. Obviously, napkins are essential in our restaurant. Now, in the middle of a busy service, for example, Saturday night, if we ran out of napkins, someone would have to run up to the store again. Now, at that time, our stores were, will we say, they just weren't organised. So what we decided to do, and this was an idea from one of our employees, that instead of replenishing the napkins on a daily basis, we created a space for napkins and we replenished them on a weekly basis. When we did a time and motion survey on the amount of time that was wasted, it turned out to be hundreds of pounds over the space of the year.
Take, for example, the housekeeping department. They realised that when they were servicing the rooms, if an item needed replenished and they didn't have it on the trolley, they had to go all the way back to the central store. While that person was being busy in doing that, it wasn't actually creating any value for the customer. It was a non-value added activity. So they realised that before they started the run in the morning, make sure that those trolleys were fully stocked with all the items they needed as they were servicing the floors, and that just cut out all that to and fro back to the stores.
I would walk around the hotel and I would often overhear employees say, that's not very lean, you know. So lean has become part of our vocabulary. It has changed the way we think. We always question ourselves, why are we doing this? Is there a value to the customer? And if there's not a value to the customer, then we ask ourselves, do we really need to do this? We plan to keep lean very much alive here at City Hotel. It really is a lot about common sense. It's looking at your processes and where you can eliminate waste. It can be used in hospitals to hairdressers, so I would absolutely recommend any organisation out there get involved in lean.